In Lab 2, we will be looking at why we have seasons and why different parts of the Earth have different temperature patterns. Lab 2 is all about energy. Energy in our exogenic Earth system comes from the sun. We call it insolation. One of the key concepts in this lab is that different materials respond to sun energy differently. Land heats and cools much more quickly than water when exposed to the same amount of insolation. Another key factor in the Earth's temperature patterns is the distribution of land and water on Earth. When you look at a globe, notice that the land in the northern hemisphere is bunched up pretty far north, while most of the land in the southern hemisphere is in the tropics. We will consider how that affects the Earth's temperature patterns. In this lab, you will work on interpreting graph data, interpreting mapped data, and synthesizing multiple pieces of evidence to explain your observations. To earn full credit on the questions that are worth a lot of points, it's really important that you cite evidence from the lab data to back up statements that you make. Okay, let's look at the lab. In part 2A, you examine insolation with graphs. The x-axis, that's the horizontal one, shows the months of the year, and the y-axis, that's the vertical one, shows the insolation in watts per meter squared. Each colored line represents a single latitude, so the red line shows the equator in each month of the year. To read the graph, select a latitude, in this case 90 degrees north, or the blue line, and a month, in this case June. Find June, select the middle of the month. Next, trace over onto the y-axis to read the insolation value. In this case, we are just under 600 watts per meter squared. This is a good opportunity to talk about precision again. In general, you should be able to estimate about halfway between the marks on a graph or measurement device. In this case, the marks are every 100 watts, so we can imagine a line at about 550 watts. Now, our line comes in above that, so we know we are greater than 550, but less than 600. So a good estimate would be 575 watts per meter squared. Next, let's look at the maps for insolation and surface temperature in part 2B. The map of insolation for January and July is on the left, and the map of surface temperature for January and July is on the right. First of all, it's important that you understand what data each map is showing. In this case, insolation is the energy received at the top of the Earth's atmosphere, before it has interacted with the atmosphere or the surface. Surface temperature is the result of insolation interacting with the atmosphere and different surface materials. As discussed in lecture, some materials, such as water, can absorb a lot of energy before they heat up or cool down. On the other hand, land heats and cools very quickly. Finally, let's look at Worksheet 3. This worksheet was created using a geographic information system and subtracting the January surface temperature from the July surface temperature. So here's July, and we subtract January from it, and we get a map with different colors which represent the amount of change between July and January. If we read the color scale, we notice that the red indicates a positive change, so areas that are red have a higher temperature in July than in January. The areas that are blue have a negative value, so these places are cooler in July than in January. That's about it. Make sure that as you answer the final question in the lab, you cite evidence from the lab data to back up the statements that you make. Let me know if you have questions. Happy trails!